Hey, how's it going? It's March 1st, 2022. This is your daily sweet talk. This is something I think I've touched on before, maybe on a stream or a video or something, I don't know. But I felt like now is a relevant time to ask the question again. Or maybe it's an inappropriate time. I don't know. Whatever. I'm just asking. I'm just talking about it. It doesn't matter what time it is. How does war work? And war crimes specifically, how can war crimes be a thing? If war crimes can be agreed upon, a crime has to be agreed upon to be a crime. Like, you agree that this is a crime that will not be done. This is the system that is in place. So, a war crime is just that, but for the world, the UN puts this in place. And I think all the countries that go to war, maybe I'm generalizing, but they're in the UN, right? Maybe North Korea isn't in the UN, but Russia is in the UN, right? I would assume so. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. But the UN, I assume, is who this is. See, this is just, I haven't done any research on this. This is just, I'm just trying to make sense of it in my head. I would imagine the UN decides upon war crimes as a group. The nations decide as a group what you can't do this in war, but then people do it anyway, and then they're tried for war crimes. But in any other circumstance, there would be crimes anyway, right? I don't know what would be a war crime specifically, but I imagine anything that would be a war crime would just be a crime in any country that it's in. Oh, it's a war crime. It's even more severe. In what way? And who is punished? The country or the person? It seems like people are punished, but aren't they acting on behalf of a country? I don't know. What I don't understand is if they can decide upon what is not allowed in war, then why is there war? Because if there's rules to war where you can't do this and here's what you can do, if you can make rules for war, then why can't you just decide to not fight and to just decide the conflict through other means that don't cost human life? It feels like it's like they're just stuck with this old system just because it's the way that it's done. War, you know, like, let's say a country is invading another country, but they still don't want to do any war crimes, I guess, right? Because otherwise, if countries didn't worry about breaking war crimes, then there wouldn't be, it wouldn't be a thing to begin with, because there would be no point in enforcing war crimes if in war you just break those crimes, you just commit those crimes all the time anyway. So I assume if a country is invading another country, they would try not to commit war crimes. If they're going out of their way to do that, then why don't they just at the start of the war just not do the war and just decide the conflict another way? I assume maybe the country being invaded would just want to be like, no, I don't want to do this. I don't want to be invaded, and I don't want to do this stupid conflict. I just want to, you know, whatever. I don't want any part of this. And with a war, you're kind of forced into it because they're invading. But then what do they do if they say no? I don't want the, then like what? Then they invade and then there's war crimes? I don't know. I don't know. It doesn't make sense to me. I don't get it. How can war crimes be enforced?